Namaste students, now my next topic is relationship between zeros and coefficient of a polynomials. Okay, in general alpha and beta are the zeros of the polynomial p of x equals to ax square plus bx plus c, where a not equal to 0 and a, b, c are real. Okay, now if a alpha and beta are the zeros of the polynomial, so x minus alpha and x minus beta are the factors of the polynomial. Okay, now x square factor, that means ax square plus bx plus c equals to x minus alpha into x minus beta into k, where k is any constant term. Now k into x is x square minus x into beta is x beta. Alpha into x is alpha x minus minus plus alpha beta. Now alpha, it can be written as x square minus alpha plus beta into x plus alpha beta. Clear? Now comparing the coefficient of x square, x and constant term on both sides, so we get ax square, the coefficient of x square is a, I am writing a, equals to the coefficient of x square is k. K into x square will be k. Now the coefficient of x is b, equals to the coefficient of x is minus k into alpha plus beta, comma the coefficient constant term is c, and the here constant term is k into alpha beta, k into alpha beta. Okay, now alpha plus beta will be b by my k, minus b by k. The value of k is a, so replacing k by a, so alpha plus beta equals to minus b by a. Clear? Now c equals to k into alpha beta. Now alpha beta will be c by k, the value of k is a, so c by a. Now alpha plus beta equals to sum of the zeros equals to minus b by a, okay, equals to minus b, that means the coefficient of x, minus the coefficient of x by a, that means the coefficient of x square, coefficient of x square. Okay, now the alpha beta, that means product of zeros. Okay, product of zeros equals to c by a. Okay, we have seen c by a, c by a equals to c, that means constant term by x a, that means the coefficient of x square, the coefficient of x square. Clear? It is my formula. Now exercise 2.2 from NCERT book. Find the zeros of the following quadratic polynomial and verify the relationship between zeros and coefficient. At first we have to find the zeros of the quadratic polynomial. Okay, question is 4 a square minus 4s plus 1. At the it is a polynomial of the variable s. Okay, now 4 a square minus 4x plus 1. So that means 4 a square, we can write 2s whole square. 2 square is 4, a square is a square. Okay, minus 2 into a, that means 4s, sorry 2s. So 2 into 2s, okay, into 1. Okay, so 2 into 2, that means 4 is plus 1 square. Clear? So here a square minus 2ab plus b square will be a minus b whole square. Here a, that means 2s, and b, that means 1. So 2s minus 1 whole square. Okay, the value of 4 square minus 4s plus 1 is 0. That means 2a square, the value of this one is 0. That means 2s minus 1 whole square will be 0. So 2s minus 1, okay, a square equals to 0. You can write a into a equals to 0. Similarly, 2s minus 1 into 2s minus 1 equals to 0. 2s minus 1 equals to 0, or 2s minus 1 equals to 0. Then s equals to half. Similarly, s equals to half. Now half and half is the zeros of the polynomial. The zeros of 4 square minus 4 is plus 1 are half and half. Okay, now let's verify the relationship between the zeros and coefficient. 0, 0, that means half. Okay, and coefficient, that means 4, 4, 1. Clear? Now, sum of the zeros equals to alpha plus beta. Alpha, that means the value of alpha is half and the value of beta is half. Okay, so sum of the zeros equals to alpha plus beta equals to half plus half will be 2 by 2. Okay, half plus half will be 1. So 1 equals to, you can write 4 by 4. Okay, equals to minus 4 by 4, minus plus 4. Okay, now minus 4 is the coefficient of x, minus coefficient of x. Okay, the coefficient of x, that means minus 4. Now 4 is the coefficient of x square, the coefficient of x square, x is s. Okay, the coefficient of s and coefficient of s square. Clear? Now next, product of zeros. Product of zeros, that means alpha beta. Okay, alpha beta equals to half into half will be 1 by 4. 2 into 2 is 4. Okay, so 1, that means 1 by 4. 1, that means constant term. Here constant term is 1. So I am writing 1. Constant term by 4 is the coefficient of square. Okay. Yes. Now, my second question is, find the zeros of the quadratic polynomial 3x square minus 6 minus 4 and verify the relationship between the zeros and coefficient. Okay. 3x square minus 6 minus 4. Okay. Now, 3 into 4 is 12. We know that. Okay. Now, we can split 4. Sorry, we can split 12. 4, 3. 4 minus 3. Okay. Now, 3x square minus 4 minus 3 into x minus 4. 3x square, 4 into x is 4x minus plus 3x minus 4. Okay. Now, here constant, here common term in x. So x into 3x minus 4 plus 3x minus 4 will be 3x minus 4 into x plus y. The value of 3x square minus 6 minus 4 is 0. So 3x minus 4 into x plus 1 equals to 0. Now 3x minus 4 equals to 0. So the value of x equals to 4 by 4. Similarly, x equals to minus 4. X plus 1 equals to 0. X will be minus 1. Now the zeros of the polynomial 3x square minus 6 minus 4 are 4 by 3 and minus 1. Okay. Sum of the zeros equals to alpha beta. The value of alpha is 4 by 3 and value of beta is minus 4. So 4 by 3 plus minus minus 1. 4 minus 3 by 3. That means 1 by 3. 1. We can write minus of minus 1 by 3. So minus 1. That means the coefficient of x. Just look, the coefficient of x is minus 1. The coefficient of x is minus 1. I am writing minus coefficient of x, because minus 1 is the coefficient of x. Coefficient of x by 3, that means coefficient of x square. Coefficient of x square. Okay, next, product of 0 equals to alpha beta equals to alpha, that means 4 by 3, beta, that means minus 1. So minus 4 by 3. Okay, now minus 4, that is constant term. Okay, so constant term by 3, that means coefficient of x square. Okay, so your homework, 1 part 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, from exercise 2.2. Clear?